As of November 3rd of 2024, there are currently 48 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is the same number as were erupting last week. One of these currently erupting volcanoes, and I might add this is a slightly controversial pick, is the Kanlaon volcano in the Philippines. Why is this pick controversial? Well, 5Oaks, the local volcano monitoring agency, does not think Kanlaon is erupting despite this footage. They think that absurdly strong degassing from its magma conduit is loosening ash emplaced by eruptions in previous years, creating intermittent emissions of ash. Kanlaon is one of the most active volcanoes in the Philippines, which, standing in the center of Negros Island, has erupted 27 times since 1900. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Indonesia, pressure is building up at the Laki-Laki cone of the Lewotobi volcano, which has unusually not erupted during the last 48 hours despite the increasing level of volcanic tremor being generated. As a result, it may soon produce a large explosive eruption. Heading west to the island of Java, the Lamongan volcano, which has not erupted since 1899, became the site of the nation's latest intrusion of magma. And, in what is this week's top story, a strong storm of earthquakes has struck a Hawaiian volcano, suggesting a potential for it to soon erupt. I am not referring to any volcanoes on Hawaii's big island, such as Kilauea or Mauna Loa, but rather the submarine volcano known as Kamaheuakanaloa. This volcano may sound unfamiliar to a majority of my audience, but this is simply because it was formerly called Loihi before being renamed in 2021. Kamaheuakanaloa last erupted in 1996, and its summit lies at a great depth of 975 meters or 3,189 feet below sea level. It is the closest volcano to the modern center of the Hawaiian hotspot, and one day will form the next Hawaiian island between 20,000 and 100,000 years from now. While the Kilauea volcano has been erupting at a high rate for 280,000 years, Kamaheuakanaloa has also been erupting at a high rate for a lesser time span, specifically for 150,000 years. Its recent eruptions have been signaled by very strong earthquake swarms, with lava fusion only being detected by subsequent surveys checking for topographic changes on the sea floor. However, not all earthquake swarms at the submarine volcano signal eruptions, although all do signal the shallow movement of magma. The recent earthquake swarm in question began on November 1st at 2:54 p.m. local time, and during the next 36 hours encompassed at least 42 earthquakes larger than or equal to magnitude 1.7. 9 of these earthquakes rated larger than a magnitude 3, and one quake in particular rated as a magnitude 4.3 on November 2nd. Yet, while magma is clearly moving, this swarm is still a far cry from the intensity observed during previous volcanic eruptions, so I personally do not believe an eruption to be actively occurring there. Meanwhile, on Indonesia's island of Flores, the Lewotobi volcano has once again gained my attention. Its activity had slowly intensified during the last month until, in the last 10 days, it produced a medium-sized explosive eruption every 6 hours fairly regularly. Then, on November 1st, it appears that a new batch of magma intruded underneath the volcano. Yet, there now appears to be a plug which has formed, as it has been more than 48 hours since an explosive event occurred. As a result, exclusion zones were expanded in multiple sectors. Then, at 3 minutes before midnight on November 3rd, a powerful blast occurred as it shattered the plug. This generated the tallest eruption plume Lewotobi has ever created, sending a plume of ash to an altitude of 40,000 feet or 12,192 meters. While the exact extent and effects of this eruption are still unclear, social media footage seemingly showed a heavy downpour of lapilli thundering off roofs, smashing car windows, and accumulating on the ground, alongside reports of very hot particles of lapilli, which caused the skin to feel like it was burning upon contact with these pieces, but not causing any actual burns. It also appears that either a long-distance lava bomb ignited a house, or a hot piece of lapilli ignited hay, which has a very low ignition temperature. Heading west to the island of Java, a magmatic intrusion is seemingly ongoing at the Lamongan volcano and has been since November 1st, specifically underneath this labeled point. This generated a swarm of 63 earthquakes, 48 of which occurred during a 2-hour time span. Alongside this, a taller degassing plume was generated from its summit, rising half a kilometer above its crater. However, there is some good news. Intrusions have occurred 5 other times during the last 40 years at this volcano, and each of these was more substantial than what was recently observed. So, while this activity does require further monitoring, it probably won't end up doing anything. And now, here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 3rd of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, MindZ, for supporting my work.